I am not very good at thinking, and I want to do a build challenge. Something kind of like the one I did in the past, but I can't come up with anything. So, I'm making other people come up with things for me. A few days ago on Twitter, I made a post about replying with any block you want, and I got a bunch of replies, and that is going to be my block palette. And we're gonna try to build something using every single one of those blocks. So let's see how it turns out. Real quickly before we get into the video, only about 1% of people who watch my videos are subscribed. So if you wanna real quickly just go down there and check that subscribe button, make sure you're subscribed. It helps me out a ton as a small creator who's hoping to grow in the future. Other than that, I hope you enjoy the video. First from CaveYT, we have Melon Block. And I'm already not liking where this is going, but I mean, there could be some pretty good stuff that I could possibly do with a melon. Maybe. We'll see. Next from Crimson, we have Crimson Planks. Honestly, that's really surprising. I don't know why. I don't know why they chose Crimson Planks. But we'll just put that right next to here. Obviously, this isn't what I'm actually going to be building. I'm just putting all the blocks out. Next from Squishy, we have Lightly Weathered Copper Stair. Now, I am just gonna assume that he means the waxed version, because I really don't want to deal with the non-waxed one. Fun fact, this is actually the longest name out of any item in Minecraft, so that might have been why he chose that, but that's a decent addition to the blocks. Next from Capture Saturday, we've got Blue Banner. Another really big surprise, kind of like these Crimson Planks. I'm so surprised that they would use a blue banner for that. Next from ShivySaw, we've got Endstone, and then some emojis. Alright, that's a pretty basic block, I guess. Next up, from DJ Foxy Gaming, we've got Obsidian. You know, I'm not really getting a good amount of building blocks here. I mean, those two might be able to do something, but let's just see how it goes. From Flywheel, we've got Hay Bale. Honorable mention is whatever that says. I can't read Russian, so I am just going to do Hay Bale. Another block that is not very good for building with, but you know what? I might be able to use this top texture. Next, we have Prismarine from Peb. Yes, I finally have a decent building block. From Jake, we've got Netherrack. Oh no. Before they updated these textures, Netherrack was definitely the worst texture in the game. And now that I think about it, it's probably still the worst texture in the game. Never mind, there's a worse one. We've got Bedrock. Bedrock just seems so cool to me. It's useless, but still amazing. From Ben McCracken. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with these blocks. Hopefully the next few will fix it. From Illinois Jones, Magma Block. That did not fix it at all. That made it worse. Next from Expiry, we've got Purple Terracotta. And that is actually a decent block. I mean, doesn't really go that well. Oh, wait, never mind. We got, oh, that works. That definitely works. From Detective Toad, we've got Kelp Block. Honestly, I think I should have known what I was getting myself into. From Rob, we've got Dead Coral Block. And this one looks like the brain coral, I think. I don't really know, but I'm gonna look. Okay, yeah, it's this one. It's the Dead Tube Coral Block. Okay. Next from Crispy Creamers, Note Block hit 4 times in top of Emerald. You know what? Since I'm feeling generous, we're gonna do it. We're just gonna do it. So, I guess if I'm using this in my build, which I'm gonna have to at some point, I need to have an emerald block on the bottom and then a note block on top. We'll see how that turns out. Next from the ED382, Soul Campfire. You know what? I'll take it because it's a light source and I don't have that yet. And it's not a very good light source, but it'll work. From Max, Cracked Polished Blackstone Bricks. And this is also a pretty good looking block, I guess. I mean, I've got obsidian, and I guess the dried kelp would look decent with it. We'll see. From Tymo Dirt, and I do kind of think I might be able to cheat this a little, because I could spread the dirt to make it grow into grass, and that might actually be a decent top block, but I could also use the dirt. From the prepubescent Pop-Tart, Nether Reactor Core. I mean, I would try to mod it in somehow, but I'm already on the snapshot because of this block, so I don't think that's a possibility. Only two more. From Max Jokin, we got Slime Block, and then from Lord, we've got Cyan Wool. And to be honest, I guess I can work with the Cyan Wool, but this is what we're working with. These are our blocks. And right now, I see absolutely nothing with any of these. I guess we could kind of start out by grouping these into sort of colors. So, for example, we could do like the crimson planks, the netherrack, the purple terracotta. These could potentially go together. So I think I'm going to start up by building a wall, and I kind of want to do a mixture of these three blocks. Maybe I actually kind of want to build this up a little bit, so we'll start it right here. Okay, so looks like the red, the netherrack can go on the bottom, then maybe blend into some of this crimson plank, and then at the top we could do the purple terracotta. After extending it out a bit further, this is what we've got, and I guess that's a pretty good start. Now let's move on to the floor. And I was kind of thinking wood for the floor, but we don't have any sort of wood-like colors, except we could maybe use a bit of this note block stuff. And then maybe on the inside we could have these copper stairs, because they kind of have a similar-ish color. They're a bit different, but I feel like it works decently well. I think I'm gonna try to do sort of like a hallway, and then maybe we could do like a different room at the end of it. But I think I am going to use these hay bale tops as a sort of ground, and maybe use some of those grass blocks, and I might cheat a little and path block them, because that will look a lot better. And that's technically still a grass block. We're just changing it using a shovel. All right, you know what? It's not that bad. It kind of gives it like an outdoor-ish feel. And I might even try maybe a transition, like slowly adding more of these path blocks and then transitioning them into grass blocks. And I think that is what I'm going for. Next, for some sort of pillar sort of things, and this is gonna be sort of the entrance. I said sort of a lot. Sorry about that. But that's where I'm gonna use these black-ish looking blocks. I'll take it. It's not the best, but it's also not the worst. And now that both of these are done, I need to create a sort of archway in between the two of them. I just said sort of again. But the problem with this is we only have one stair block. Most of our blocks are full blocks, which does not really help. I mean, I guess we could just kinda do that. How does that look? You know what? I'm not gonna be able to get it any better. So we'll just do it like this. You know what? That actually doesn't look too bad. And maybe we could even sneak a bit of bedrock up the side right here. Oh yeah, that works, I like that. I was about to make a joke about how expensive this is with all this obsidian, and then I remembered that we're using bedrock right here, which, I mean, is a bit expensive. And I just realized I somehow completely passed Ada's Pro's reply to my tweet. He said netherite block. So now we've got another decently expensive block to add onto our list of blocks, and I guess that also kind of works with the colors that we're dealing with here. I almost want to replace this kelp black with a netherite black. Although maybe instead we could kind of mix it in, and that way we're using both of the blacks. I think that definitely works, and it maybe even looks better, I don't know. Alright, I just finished this wall, and to be honest, it's kind of looking a bit empty, so I think I want to consider maybe opening this up and revealing the purplish stuff on the inside. And I would say that helps out quite a bit, but we still don't really have as much detail as I would be hoping for, and it doesn't line up. I also don't like the color. Maybe just straight like this? I think that's probably the best. But to be honest, I still don't really like it. Just the color of the copper doesn't really work here. Which is weird because it's kind of pinkish, which goes well with the purple, but it's just too bright. So the next thing I want to try is these soul campfires, and specifically I want to get my shovel back out and try maybe extinguishing them. Oh yeah, I think I already like that a lot better. Let's try it with the whole thing. That might work a bit better. It looks like it does look better. So I'm just gonna quickly break all the blocks from here that we've already used. So that's the crimson planks, the copper stairs, obsidian, hay, netherrack, bedrock, purple terracotta, hay bale, note block, soul campfire, polished blackstone, grass, and netherite. So we're actually off to a really good start. We've actually gotten most of the blocks already, but you know, I'm gonna need to work out the remaining two sides and then fix up the interior a bit because it's kind of lacking. So I'm just going to finish the other two sides and then I will be right back. Alright, I've completely replicated this side onto that side, so now all that's left to do is this, but I'm actually thinking that we don't end off this house here and instead kind of have a bigger room in the middle. This is going to be a pretty big thing. I'm going to have to do a lot of cuts so that this video isn't an hour long. But for right now, I want to focus on the interior right here because the walls, they're not very appealing. So I think that gives us a perfect excuse to try out some of these blocks, like the melon, for example, because this actually could make a... Alright, wait, I have to make everyone four ticks, because that's the rule. But as I was saying, this melon block right here actually might make a decent looking pillar, and if we use some of these copper stairs at the top to kind of close it off, that may actually look pretty good. And I actually really like the color transition right there. What we could even do then is have wool the next block up, because we're gonna have a roof above this building that doesn't start until the next block up. So we could have wool right here, because that kind of mixes well with the prismarine, but it's also a different block that we're using. And of course we also need some light, so I'm thinking we do a similar thing to what we have on the outside with these soul campfires and kind of have them hanging a bit like chandeliers. And it looks like this actually lines up perfectly, so we can space them out three blocks apart and they will all line up. We can also do copper stairs like this, because then they're just looking like solid blocks, and then we kind of have like bands of copper going through, and that sort of looks like it's holding these things up. And I think with that all done, the interior of this first hallway is done. So I guess now we could start on the main room. I mean, we could also do the roof, but I don't really want to start on that quite yet. There are still a few more blocks that we need to get out of the way. and especially blocks like the slime block and the magma block, I am not sure how I'm gonna use those still. And for this main room, I think I wanna use some of this coral block as part of the floor, because this actually doesn't work too badly with these copper stairs. And if we can sort of make a bit of a pattern with this, I feel like it will turn out pretty good. Do 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 do. Fun. Alright, the floor of this main room is pretty much done, and I would say this actually looks pretty nice. But of course we still have a long way to go, and specifically we need to bring up the walls. And the first thing I think I need to do is take out these bedrock pillars, because I had them in the front, and originally I thought of closing this wall off at the back and making it symmetrical, I guess. But now that we're not doing that, we don't really want those bedrock walls getting in the way. And I guess what I could do is just replicate the walls of the hallway, but in this area. You know what, instead of having prismarine here, what if we replace that with endstone? I kinda do like the blue there, but at the same time, I need to use this endstone somewhere. And I feel like it doesn't make it look that much worse where I would want to replace it. So we're just gonna go with it. And if we add the melons that we have over there, that should hopefully bring a bit of color to this area that I was trying to get with the blue over there. All right, walls are coming along, and I actually decided to bring this prismarine back in the form of pillars. I was gonna do some more melons, but then I realized that that actually might be a good spot to put some prismarine, because that's gonna flow right into the roof. And although that may not look that good, if we put stairs around it, I feel like that might make a difference. And I would definitely say that it has, so we're gonna keep it like that. Alright, I just need to thank Squishy Spag right now, because I don't know how I would be going about this if I didn't have these copper stairs. And now we've got to figure out what to do with this big open space, also known as a ceiling. Because although this may work for this area, it's definitely not gonna work over here. So we're gonna have to find something else that will work. But I do still want to have a little cyan wool border right here. Now we've got a sort of square, and I guess we could do another layer with more copper stairs. And I guess we probably should have another layer of cyan wool. And of course we couldn't forget our soul campfire lights. So let's put just a few of them around in the middles of each section. And now we have to figure out what to do with this big square. Of course, the first thing that comes to mind would be to sort of make an indent with more of the stairs. And maybe we can try out the magma block here, just because I don't know how else we're gonna use it. Oh, it's really dark, but I would say it actually does work decently well there. Now we just have to figure out a way to light these areas. So now the only thing left to do is fix this mess on the outside, because while we were doing that interior, we made this look really bad. We only have two blocks left to use, slime block and blue banner. And I don't think that's gonna work that well on a roof. Obviously, the first thing that comes to mind again is copper stairs. And I think we're gonna go with this sort of shape for the roof. Not really a flat roof, but not really a pointy roof either. Kind of curved. And on second thought, I kinda wanna change the layout of those stairs. So if we go like this, that will look a lot better. And of course, I'm probably just gonna fill this whole top in with the copper stairs then. But the last thing I need to figure out is what to do in the middle right here. I think that is a finished product for the front. Alright, another big cut time. I'm gonna do the entire outer wall and roof, and then I'll be back and we'll sort out those remaining two blocks. And this thing is now fully walled and ceilinged and roofed and all of that stuff. And now that that's all done, it's just time to put the finishing touches on this thing, and that is using these last two blocks. Now, the blue banner shouldn't actually be that hard, though. Let's see, if we just put it on the wall, like right here at different intervals, I would say that looks pretty good. I would almost say it looks better than before. Before, these walls were kind of lacking in detail. And now that that's done, all that's left is the dreaded slime block. What am I gonna do with this thing? Hopefully this actually works, but if we cover the sides and then put a soul campfire in that spot right there, I don't want the cyan wool. Oh yeah, and that goes through perfectly fine. Although smoke also goes through. So what we could do is move it down one block, put it on the bottom, and then have two slime blocks that should stop all the smoke. Yep. So now all we gotta do is replicate it on the other sides. And now that that's done, that means every single block has been used. And this is our final product. I gotta say, this turned out way better than I was expecting from the block palette that we had. Because, I mean, those were not very promising blocks. This spot is the perfect spot for a thumbnail. But, of course, now that the building's all done, the video also has to end. Because, you know, I'm not gonna make the video go on when I'm done with everything. So, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, subscribe, comment, and all that stuff too. And other than that, goodbye.